Polish-American Connection on BCTV is supported by the following.
Greetings and welcome. This is the Polish American Connection TV show, and I'm the producer and host, Tom Gajewski. We want to welcome you today. We have a very interesting and informative program for you, particularly if you're a student who's in your senior year in high school, or if you're a parent or a relative of one, because we're going to give you some information on how you may be able to help finance some of your education going forward. Let me introduce to you our Before I start with introductions, let me remind you, you may want to get a paper and pencil because we have some, particularly some announcements at the end of the show, and there's some information in this show that you might want to make note of as well. And I also want to take this opportunity to express condolences to Susie Carl and family. Her brother Richard passed away. And the Carl family has been an important part of East Reading and our East Reading extended family for many years. So we want to extend our sincere condolences. But let me introduce to you our very special guests today. First of all, we have Mary Ann Zerkowski, who's been involved. And in fact, the two ladies combined here today probably have close to 70 years of community service work in our Berks County and Reading area community. And we want to thank them for that. They've done a lot to make things better here for our community. First of all, Mary Ann's been involved and serves as president for the Polish American Board of Education for, I believe, over 30 years, Mary Ann.
Yes.
A long time. And she's also served as co-chair of the 1992 Columbus Day Parade. She was one of three founders of the Polish American Heritage Association and served as its president or co-president for a number of years. She's been active in St. Mary's Roman Catholic Church for many years. She's been principal of various Reading schools. She's also a member and served as vice president of Southern Junior High School, Middle School, Alumni Association Board of Directors. So, Mary Ann, thank you for your service and welcome.
Thank you, Tom, and good evening.
Before we get started, I'd like to introduce Sandy as well.
Oh, okay.
Let me also introduce to you Sandy Hummel, who's certainly not is not last or not least, I should say. She's been active with the Antietam Swim Association. She serves on the board and has been the vice president of the Polish American Heritage Association. She serves as scholarship chairperson for the Polish American Board of Education and for the Polish American Heritage Association. And she's a founder, one of the founders and co-chairs of the East Reading Reunion Committee. She's done a lot of things, plus 38 years, I believe, in personnel for the city of Reading.
Correct.
Long time. So she's done a lot for our community, too. So welcome, Sandy, to you.
Thank you, Tom.
You're welcome. Thanks to both of you for being here. Let me start with Mary Ann. First of all, how many years has the Polish American Board of Education been giving scholarships?
79 years.
A long time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. They started in 1945,
was it?
1945.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Very good. And how long have you been involved?
Close to just over 30 years.
Over 30 years, okay.
I've been chairman of the scholarship committee and also president of the of the organization. When I went up to Harrisburg to meet with the Secretary of Education, when I first became a principal, the driver used to hound me. He was a reading teacher over at Governor Mifflin. And we used to go up every so many months together. And he would hound me about taking over this organization. Mm-hmm. And I had enough. At the time, I was a principal of the Amanda South School in the Reading School District. And
my grade school, by the way.
Well, your grade school.
Right.
And I really had enough on my plate at that time than to listen to him talk about his Polish organization. But he was worried, as the other people who were active were worried, about who was going to take over when they all died. And now we're in the same position, and that's when I have Sandy here. Because my health is not good, and we need someone to take over. And and thank you for I neglected to thank you for permitting Sandy and I to speak to your many Polish American listeners and friends about the 79th anniversary of the Polish-American Board of Education. During 2020, or 2024, I wrote this in 2020, PABE will celebrate 79 years of helping Berks County students of Polish-American descent with their college expenses. Special thanks to the leaders of the Polish American organizations for having the foresight to create this remarkable program on November 25th, 1945. Now, I was 2 years old. I was 2 years old when this organization was created.
Good timing, though, right after World War II.
Yeah. Well, it was during World War II, really, that, well, maybe there things were talked about during the 40s, during the war, but they were not brought to fruition. The scholarship program helped to make many college and career dreams come true, and has lessened the financial burden on many families. Mm-hmm. We have seen the program to help to shape the careers of many business professionals, doctors, musicians, scientists, educators, and performers, as well as many other career paths.
How much money in scholarships has been given out to date, roughly?
Roughly? Let's see. About 480 scholars received scholarships for a total of about $800,000.
It's a lot of money and a lot of help.
Yeah, a lot of. And we really respect people like you and Sandy, who helped to make our organization relevant.
Well, under your leadership.
Well, that's not neither here nor there, because we have a lot of good people in the organization who helped it's not only me.
A lot of good people in the Polish community.
Yeah, yeah.
If I could just hold these up. Maybe, Sandy, if you want to hold that one up. These are some of the recognitions. You have to kind of hold it up though, so they can get it on the camera. The organization over the years has received recognitions from the Pennsylvania State House of Representatives, from the Pennsylvania State Senate, and from the United States Congress. So there have been recognitions both at the state level and nationally for the work of the Polish American Board of Education under Marianne's leadership and under the leadership of the leaders prior to Marianne's coming on board. So there's a lot to be proud of. Let's go to, thank you, Marianne. Let's go to Sandy so that we can.
I'm going to tell a little about the history, and then Sandy's going
to. We don't have much time, Marianne. We have to cut it short. I'm sorry.
Okay.
I apologize. I wish we had an hour, but we don't.
Okay.
So Sandy, if we may, to qualify, must the person, the applicants, have some connection with Polish ancestry?
Yes, they must be able to prove that they are Polish.
Mm-hmm.
And that could be in various ways. It could be through birth certificates, death certificates, DNA, you know, ancestry, and 23andMe are popular right now.
Mm-hmm.
So those are some of the options that they can try to prove their Polish heritage.
They can't just like pierogies, though, huh?
No. Unfortunately not.
Okay. Seriously, and then are there other requirements as well?
They have to be one of a senior in a Berks County High School, and there are other qualifications. They must provide their ACT or SAT scores if they're available, and they must also provide their GPAs from their high school.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Okay, and How many scholarships are there this year, and how much are they worth?
This year, for the 2024-2025 school year, we're giving out 10 scholarships totaling $24,000.
Mm.
And that is separate from the Polish American Heritage Scholarship, which I believe they were on a previous show of yours,
mm-hmm.
Of $2,500.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So quite a bit of money.
Yes.
Quite a bit of help for Polish students of Polish ancestry who go on to college. And if a student or a parent wants more information or has questions, where can they get an application?
Okay, the applications and guidelines have been sent to all Berks County high schools, so I'm assuming they have them in the guidance office.
Mm-hmm.
We have it on our website, which is www.paberks.org.
Mm-hmm.
And they can contact myself, and my email is sahummel, and that's H-U-M-M-E-L, at ptd.net.
Mm-hmm.
Or they may call me at 610-207-7065.
Okay, very, very good. And thank you to both of you for your service to this organization and for your service to the community over the years. You both have done a lot, so it's appreciated. You probably don't get enough thanks for your work, but it certainly is appreciated. I'm sure there's a lot of people that feel that way. Okay. Well, at this point, then, we're going to move on with announcements. If we could show the announcements that we have, please. Okay, I think that's the last one, John. There we go. Polish American Heritage Association has its February meeting on Sunday, the 16th of February at 2:00 in room 325 in the Goggle Works, and that's at 2nd and Washington Street. There's free parking in the rear of the building, and guests are welcome. If you want to find out what Polish American Heritage Association is all about, you're welcome to come there and listen to a meeting and find out for yourself. The Polish American Heritage Association has a cultural center And if we can move on to that. No, we're, somehow we got out of order here. Polish American Heritage Association has a culture. No, still not right. Not so, well, we can do that one. There we go. Cultural Center is open on Sundays from noon to 4 p.m. at the Goggle Works, fifth floor, second and Washington Streets, free admission, free parking in the rear of the building. It's a rich opportunity to learn and to get entertainment. And also there's a lot of opportunities for volunteers. If you're interested, you can call Marilyn at 610-779-5523. And there's no admission charge to get in. And it's really interesting, and there are a lot of themes throughout the year. Like there's a Christmas theme, there's something usually connected with Easter, there's something connected with around Valentine's Day for marriages. So by all means, take advantage of that. Let me see what we have listed there next. Our next one, please. Okay, we're doing them a little out of order, but the East Reading Reunion is scheduled for Sunday, September 15th from noon to 6 at the Liederkranz, 143 Spook Lane. It's a chance to renew old friendships, see former neighbors, make new friends. And if you're interested, you can go to Facebook and go to the East Reading Reunion 2024 for information, or you can call either Sandy or myself. Sandy is at 610-207-7065, or me at 610-698-8731. And if we can go to the next one, please. You can join the fun involved with Southern Junior High School, Middle School. We have an alumni association. If you're more interested in more information, you can contact Harry Eisenbeis at 610-823-7905. Or me at 610-698-8731. Can we go to the next one, please? The International Folk Show with Victor Marinsky is on the second Wednesday of every month at 8 o'clock, Comcast Channel 15, Service Electric Channel 17. Next one, please. The scholarship program for the Polish American Heritage Association. And there are some special requirements for this, and what you might want to do is contact Chris Curtis, who's the vice president of the Polish American Heritage Association, who's handling this particular scholarship this year, at 484-256-9603. Okay, by all means, give Chris a call. It's a special program. It's set up with special requirements, so you can contact Chris at that number. Okay, can we go to the next one, please? There's a Pierogi sale at St. Mary's Roman Catholic Church at 12th and Spruce Streets in Reading. It's in the church lower hall, which is on the right side of the church as you face it. It's every Friday beginning the 16th of February through Lent until the 22nd of March. That would be the Friday before Good Friday, from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m., and they have potato, sauerkraut, and you'll note I have a question mark after cheese because I was told that they're not sure they're going to be able to do cheese this year. I'm not sure of the reasons. They can explain that to you, but if they're able to, they want to do cheese because they're very popular. $10 per dozen, and that's frozen, and it's first come, first serve until they're gone. So if you want to get there, the best thing to try to do is get there as early in the morning as you possibly can. And then I think we have one more. Southern Junior High School is having a breakfast reunion on Saturday, March 16th at 2020 this year at 9 a.m. at Wegmans Restaurant. And if you're interested in information on that, you can contact me at 610-698-8731. Donna Lewandowski-Bird at 610-914-4730. Or Lynn DiAcosta at 610-781-2897. I think that's all we have. Okay, with that, I'd like to say thank you very much for watching. We hope you enjoyed the program. If you have any questions regarding the PABE scholarships, you can contact Sandy Hummel at
610-207-7065 or you can email me at sahummel@ptd.net.
Okay, very good. And thank you both again for being here, and thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for watching. And until the next time, which will be the first Tuesday in March, Tuesday the 5th of March at 7:30, Comcast Channel 15, Service Electric Channel 19. Take care, God bless, and always be proud to be Polish.
Polish American Connection on BCTV is supported by the following.